Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube, and as an engineer, I have traveled across many, many bridges, including this one. It's been about 20 years, back when it was still under CSX. Now it belongs to the Allegheny Valley Railroad. It was CSX and single track when I ran on it. Before that, it used to be the B&O, and it was double track. There was once a location where a separate bridge ran over to an island, which was more of a slaughterhouse type island. True story. Now, this video, I just want to show you from the drone a vantage point that you're not going to get from the ground to help with your modeling. This isn't going to go into a lot of detail about bridge design, but I will link a video that has way more information than I can give in this. This is just going to be for modeling ideas, everything so you can see the color of bridges, see the way they have their walkways, to give you a better view of how piers are designed, the spacing between piers, the different kinds of piers, and other things you may not have thought about. This is over top of the Allegheny River. And it is interesting, things you don't think about. Like, yes, they had to use two bridges. They weren't going to have one bridge cover the whole span, so they made two bridges. Now, rust plays no importance on the sturdiness of the bridge. It's just surface rust. So railroads really don't care. They're not going to go spend money to paint railroad bridges. Now here, there is a switch right before the river where this will go down onto the spur. And I want to show you this. Here, look at that. Now look how long this span is. And that heads towards Bloomfield. And so yes, this trestle leading up to the bridge is really neat. And it was just recently redone. So a lot of times I see trestles on people's layouts and they really don't know how far apart to space the trestle spans. It's a long lead to get up that hill. And it is amazing, in a bad way, that people would risk their lives to climb to the top of a bridge just to tag it, but it happens. You would have known it if you just saw this from the ground. Bridges are actually probably the safest part of a railroad because they're inspected often. And they were built for longevity. A lot of these bridges are over 100 years old. Personally, I have no fear going over a bridge. It's traveling along the riverbank, or along a cliff with rock slides. That's the stuff that makes us engineers nervous, not bridges. Now here's a bridge I've been across thousands of times. This is CSX double track down in Port View, Pennsylvania, over the Youghiogheny River. The Youghiogheny River is not very deep, and it does not get large boats. So you don't need anything really tall and massive to cover this. But the one thing that I'm taking away from watching this video now that I really never gave much thought to is I used to think that all the bridge piers had to be at a 90 degree angle to the bridge. And obviously they don't, because look at the angle. The bridge piers are in a way that allows the water to pass through smoother. And a lot of times I see people make concrete piers, but they don't weather them. And concrete weathers just like everything else. Another bridge I go across pretty much daily is up in Beaver Falls. This is the Ohio River, the Big Beaver Bridge. And this is over 100 years old. It's a masterpiece. And here we have a westbound CSX train going across. This is double track. As big as the bridge is, it still wasn't enough, so they had to make an additional bridge. It's a really special and unique design. Now, if you are making one for your layout and you're going to have boat traffic, you'll sometimes want to put red LEDs on the piers where the boats should not be passing through and green LEDs on the areas where they do. I was in Harrisburg and I got a concrete viaduct. It's one of the longest ones. But wait, there's more and more. Look at this. Three in a row. Look at that. Yeah, some places they're not going to go with the standard truss bridge. They're going to go with concrete viaducts. And this is over the Susquehanna River. One thing this video should show is that there's not a universal type of bridge for every situation. Depending on the geography and the time period, different bridges will exist. And so when working on your layout, decide what's going to be best for you. Is a concrete viaduct going to look correct for your time period and for your location? Or would a steel truss bridge look better? This is still beautiful architecture. And some interesting things I want to show you is kind of think outside the box. You can put an interlocking on a bridge. If you look back here, we are still on the viaduct, and there is an interlocking. And it's not the only place you'll see track arrangements like that. On the Union Railroad, they also put a set of crossovers on a bridge. And we'll take a look at the other direction. And they also have a truss bridge with a switch in the middle of a truss bridge. Now those are going to be powered, just like the one here for CSX and McKeesport. So start getting creative with your bridges. I just want to show you a bunch of different ideas. Give you some ideas on how to paint, how to weather, and I hope you enjoyed it. Well, I have a lot more videos coming up, so please subscribe to my channel, DJSTRAINS. Hit the bell icon to be notified of future videos. I'll probably put out another 4 videos within the end of this month and into June. So subscribe. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, also as DJSTRAINS. And if you want to connect with me, go through my Patreon, all in the description below.